And some of you pastors that are out there, you are under a spell of these false prophets. They blinded your eyes. You pastors, listen to me. When you hear us warning the church and start calling us names, listen to me, pastors, across this, you apostles, bishops, all of those born again big titles that you are holding now. Those big titles you call yourselves. If you are an apostle and a bishop and you lack discernment of knowing this is a fake. This is a fake man. That power is not of God. This is a liar. This is truth. And you call yourself apostle, a bishop, an overseer, you have fallen far away. If you are a compromiser, you can't even stand. And you say, I'm a pastor. But when it comes to righteousness and holiness and the fear of the Lord and leading the people of God in the right direction, I have no side. If I stand with Pastor Senyonga to promote righteousness and holiness, people might look at me differently. But if I stand on the other negative side, also some good, I might lose some good people. So for me, I have no side. That has never been in the Bible. To be able to stand nowhere. Be a lukewarm leader. When righteousness calls. When holiness knocks. First of all, pastors, leaders, apostles, prophets must rally together to lift the banner of righteousness for the nation in Jesus' name. Don't bring politics here. Politics does not belong in the church. Who is with who? Who says what? Who is playing this? Who says so? Who is, you know, just going with the flow? Who is posting? Who is not? All of those stuff. Who is with who? Who has a bigger following? Don't bring it here. We are not here for a following. We are here to follow Jesus. We are not here to be liked. No. We are not here to be what people want us to be. No, we are here to stand on the word of God. And you leaders and pastors, you're going to have to decide which altar are you going to sacrifice on. There's an altar of Baal and Athres. There is that altar is led by witchcraft in partnership with idolatry and adultery. That is the altar where rapes go on in churches. Raping young boys. Raping young girls, forcing young men into homosexual rapes. There is an altar in Uganda for those things. And if that's where you are going as a pastor, and if you are subscribing to that altar, you are going to hear the voice of Pastor Senyonga. I am not the first one to say these things. A documentary from BBC. British Broadcasting Corporation. Did a very big research. Two researches. One in Uganda. One in Nigeria. The first one was in Uganda. And they were investigating about cultic churches hiding in the name of Christianity. In that documentation, if you missed it, I'm going to play it on Friday. That was about Uganda. In that documentary, they highlighted people that are sacrificing people to demons and butchering their lives in order to get power. In Uganda. And that's not Pastor Senyonga. That is BBC. These were serial killers. And they were confessing that some of us were part of that cult. The people were saying they were part of that cult. Not us, but those people in that documentary. And they admitted they are playing tricks in churches to lure the gullible among the believers. That was not Pastor Senyonga. I don't even know who produced it. And I never cared enough to even dig out for that information. But it was there and highlights those kind of people. So that is not Pastor Senyonga. These things are happening. And they said they were killing several people. Now, here you are. You are hearing Pastor Senyonga saying, yes, they were a lot of serial killing from the information that comes our way. So you know it's true. But what happens? You are lied to by hearing another person says, Pastor Senyonga promised us mass graves. Where are they? What will you do with that information if I gave it to you? What would you give? The very people that are asking for those kind of questions are the ones who are going to say, can you prove that we're actually killed by these cults? Because even when truth is glaring, those kind of people, they are going to say, how do we believe the report is authentic? Because these days, you are hearing some truth. But when they hear the truth, they poke holes in truth. A man says, I was in that church. This was done against me. And the other one. And another person comes out. And another person comes out. 10 people come out. For 10 years. For 20 years. You still cannot believe. Because you have a veil. You have a veil. God keeps warning you. By or through different testimonies, different reports, different issues, you keep not listening because you are on the way to perdition. Perdition. So, those kind of people will never believe anything. So, one of the reasons why they would like to get this carnal evidence is to find a way of fighting it. How do you fight it? Let us know if it's there so we can fight it and erode it and destroy the message and the messenger. So listen to this. This is now beyond reasoning. In Uganda, if you are here and you know what's going on, the fact that some pastors are fake is not a mystery anymore. If you think it's still a mystery, you are lost. Even heathens, even the non-believers, they know in Uganda they are fake pastors. Playing gimmicks on the platform. Going to witch doctors in the night. And on Sunday they are on the platform. Holding a Bible. Declaring, Jesus is healing you. Jesus is healing you. You think your Jesus is their Jesus. Your Jesus is different from these people's Jesus. Yours is in heaven. He rose from the dead. He has power and authority and is coming back. Theirs is a fake one. On the surface, he has a name. And they give him Jesus. But inside and privately, it is a demon. It is a demon. That's why Jesus said, fake Jesus will come up. Fake Jesus will come up. And they will deceive many. So these people, when they say Jesus, they don't mean your Jesus. They are meaning their Jesus. Who they want to present to you, who is actually a demon and a devil that they were sacrificing to that last night. And they made a covenant with him that in order to deceive many, I have to call you Jesus. So every time I say Jesus, you know I'm calling you Rubari. I am calling you Amayembe. So adira amayembe naga tume erinya Yesu kubanga amanyi Yesu lyerinya litunda, naimira ku kituuti nakola ebya sitani byonna.
He plays gimmicks and everything.
Okulimba,
the lies,
okugwa ebigwa ebitaliyo,
falling falsely,
okuwa obunnabbi obutaliyo,
giving false prophecy,
kulotera ebirooto ebitaliyo n'okubivuunula ebitaliyo,
interpreting falsely of dreams,
ebirala bakosa divination spirits.
Omwoyo gw'okwera guzala guzo.
Kubanga amayembe ago nago gayina bye gamanyi ebitonotono. Oyinza okugenda ew'omusamize n'akugamba yo amazima amatonotono, bw'aba n'akutwala mugega n'akuyamba okugenda mugge yeena. Sitaani ayinza okugamba yo obunnabbi obw'ekirimba naye nga ye abulimbisa agezaako kulimba
that he's trying to manipulate and lie you.
Yogera,
but what he's speaking
actually nga bitufu
could be facts.
Kati gwe bogamat buli ayogera ekitufu aba wa mukama.
So if you think that whoever speaks the truth about your life is
genda mu Bible yolabe,
go to the Bible, check through.
Emizimu
demons
jakwatanga kana akawala.
They used to possess a young girl.
Nga buli batume bwe bayita obwebati.
Whenever the apostles used to pass.
Nga aga abo batume ba Katonda.
This girl would say, those are the servants of God.
Abo muweres abaweresa Katondo wa waguru.
They serve the Most High.
Oya babe basajja ba Katonda.
Those are the men of God.
Aba Yuda yanga te babakiririzamu.
The Jews were not believing in them.
Aba Saddukayo yanga te babakiririzamu.
Neither were the Sadducees.
Bannamateeka nga baagala batta.
Even the scribes hunted them to kill.
Abaroma nga babakyawa.
The Romans hated them.
Nga teri abayita baweereza ba Katonda.
Nobody called them servants of God.
Nga babayiganya baagala batta.
They were persecuted almost to death.
Naye guno omuzimu.
But this spirit
of divination
ogw'okweraguza
ogwali ku mwalo ono nga buli bayitawo webati bagenda okubuulira enjiri ng'agamba abo be baweereza ba Katonda ali waggulu ennyo. Kati omuzimu gwali mutuufu? Siwulidde omuzimu gwali mutuufu? Naye gwali mulokole?
But was it saved?
Gwali kugenda mu ggulu?
Was it going to heaven?
No. Shitani asobola kulimbalimba yo.
Can manipulate and lie you.
No bunabbi.
Even with a prophecy.
Na kama gero.
Or a miracle.
No buboni no bwenjawulo.
And some signs.
Era seta Bible yegamba.
The Bible says.
Shitani agenda kolo bubonero.
The devil will also perform signs.
Nebya magero.
And miracles.
Mubisere byo luvanyuma.
In the end times.
Asobola kuchamya abanji.
So that he can lure many to hell.
Sitani ainayo twanyi.
The devil has his small power.
Tolooza nti ye jajjawo.
So he's not your granny.
Yayika amanyo.
Who is totally empty.
Oinzo kuloza sitani alinga jajjawo yayika amanyo aina nembogobogo ye naina akadiye atambula agoma. No. Oli yali malaika.
The devil was an angel. He was not an angel.
Ati,
so when he became fallen,
he had
enough fame
ne favor emala,
and enough favor
okuli imba imba ye, ekitundu cha kusatu, echaba malaika.
To even entice a third of angels.
Can you imagine? You can convince a third of the angels to walk away from God. That's an influence. And when he came down here, he came with some power. Not all the power, but some power. That's why the biggest thing about the devil is a demon of convincing. He's called a tempter, a seducer, a liar. So he uses lies to seduce, to lure, to blind and make you walk into the darkness. That is his power.
If you listen to the devil,
you would think he's right. You would think he's good. By listening to him, he's a good liar.
There are some people that if when they lie, you just see them clearly. They begin to blink. They stutter. They stammer.
Atunula wansi.
They look down.
Engalo nastand because kulabanga atali ali uncomfortable.
They try to twitch the hand.
Naye Satani.
But the devil.
Agira bwati.
He stands bold.
Naga mukama favorazufa.
I tell you, praise the Lord.
Muli mutiyo.
How are you?
Kakati kankubulire.
Now let me tell you this.
Nakutunula bwati.
They look at you directly.
Na kulimba.
First head on. By the time the conversation is done, you are already a follower and a liker. That is what he did to Adam. The same thing he did to other people. It's the same thing he's doing.
He's a good liar. Once he lies, you will never know. That's why he lures, he tempts, he seduces, he brings people in. And that's why many people would stay in that church and they will never know the truth, because the devil is a good liar. They will never know the truth and they actually will hate the truth and they love the lies. Even when there is a smoke and some signs that something is wrong somewhere in this place, about this man, about that woman, about this pastor, about that apostle, even when there are signs, when God is trying to warn them, guess what? They will still speedily run to support a lie before the truth, before they even support the truth. Even in the last day, when the truth is glaring, they would say,
come what may, I am a die hard of so and so.
So they are attaching themselves to a person than to the truth. And that's sad. And that's what the apostle said. And that's what Jesus said. That they are going to actually lure many and take them away even from the elect. n'ekitundu ekimu okuvamu abo abalondebwa
even the elect mubalokole mwennyini
mujja
kuvaamu abantu bagoberere obulimba
ne
bannabbi b'obulimba wanika emikono gae mu linnya lya Yesu oyo si yenze tali banze n'abaana bange mukama abakuume mu linnya lya Yesu kubira Yesu engalo.
Love for Jesus mightily.